Hey everyone, I've been making a few videos today, and this will be my last one, and then I'm going to crash. Let me just pick this hat up. As you can see, it's getting late. I don't know if you can see that clock, but it's after midnight. I just couldn't sleep, so I figured I'd make a couple of videos. I have the X22i incline trainer. Step up on here, and this looks familiar if you have an X22i, an 11i, I don't know what other eyes they have. I know they have the 32i, which is really would like to have, but I'm just extremely happy I have something, especially with all this coronavirus stuff going around. I don't have to worry about going outside. I could self-quarantine, and if I need to do exercise, I do it right on here. All right, today's video is going to show you, it's an updated video on how to install Netflix. The reason I'm doing this video again is because the last video I had on how to install Netflix didn't really show you how to get into the privileged mode. And if you haven't seen any of my videos before, which I'm assuming you may have if you've got to this video, when I say privileged mode, it's like the administrator mode. It's how you access, there's an Android desktop that's incorporated into the X22i's, the 32i's, and some of the other machines. If you have a console on your machine with a screen like this, even the S22 bicycles, the bike has it as well. If you've got a screen, then you have access to a desktop, to an administrator mode that you can gain access. And then once you gain access, you can install apps, you can access web browsers, stuff like that. Now you'll have people that say, hey, isn't that hacking the system? You can say it's hacking, but it's not really hacking because you're not installing anything or you're not really changing anything on the machine. And again, the great thing about it is, let's say you have to call a rep or a tech to fix something on your treadmill, you can just back out of the privileged mode and it's like they'll never see. So here you go. So the first thing we'll do is we'll access privileged mode. You probably, if you've seen my videos before, you know it's a sequence of tapping on this screen. So what I do is I tap 10 times anywhere where it's not going to activate anything. I'm sure I can do it on here too. I don't know if this changes anything. Weekly stats. So I'm going to try doing it in this area here. Because if I click here, it's going to click on that. So let's try doing it here, just anywhere in there. We'll click 10 times, we'll wait 7 to 10 seconds, and then we'll click 10 times again. And then down here, it should say privileged mode equals true. Because right now, if you swipe up from the black or swipe down from the black, you're not seeing anything. You can tell if you're in privileged mode because you'll swipe and you'll get three shapes. So you'll get a triangle, a circle, and a square. And that's how you know you're in privileged mode, but it's not working. So let's tap anywhere where it doesn't activate anything. We'll try tapping right here. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 1,000, 2, 1,000, 3, 1,000, 4, 1,000, 5, 1,000, 6, 1,000, 7, 1,000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And there you go. Privilege mode equal true. What happens now? If I swipe up, there's my three shapes. And if I click on that, look at that. I've actually have my desktop. Now your desktop will probably look something like this. This is the desktop you'll have when you first log on. You're not going to have any of these things because I've done some changes to this. But anyway, this is the desktop you'll have. You'll have nothing on it. I have some shortcuts and I can show you how to do that later. You'll click on that and then you'll have this. You won't have all these icons. You'll only have several. You'll have the browser, the camera. Yep, there's a camera up there. You'll have the clock, the downloads, the gallery. You'll have the iFit admin, which I don't know why it's there, but I guess it's supposed to be. iFit Cardio is the actual iFit software. And then you'll have settings. So if you hit iFit Cardio, see it comes back. So let me go to home, and this is what you're used to. So let's swipe up and bring the desktop up, okay? And then we're gonna click on there. And the first thing you do if you wanna install Netflix, I already have Netflix there, so let me uninstall it. So that you could see how it works. All right. How do you install Netflix? First thing you do is once you come to the desktop, you'll click there and you go to the web browser. Once in the web browser, you'll actually Google and look for Netflix. there's Netflix. You'll click on Netflix. And there it is. Now, if you haven't logged on, you'll have to log on. So once you're logged on, you'll see this page. Now, here's the funny part about this. Let's say I want to watch Pandemic. I mean, how appropriate is that? It'll say web page not available. So Netflix doesn't work from the web browser. But that's not a problem. Because in order to get the Netflix software, it's an APK file. There's a way you can do that right from the Netflix page. So once you log in, you'll see your name up there. You'll click on your name, and you'll see it says Help Center. Do you see where it says that? You click on Help Center, and then you'll get a type of Help Center with what do you need help with. You'll get a COVID-19, talks about we're sorry for inconvenience, and hey, we're all dealing with COVID-19. Hopefully you guys are doing okay. In here, you're going to search for APK and then hit search. It's not case sensitive. It's going to bring up several things, but the very first thing it says is Netflix says this app is not compatible with your device. You're going to read the article. And you can read the article if you want, but the main thing you're looking for is right here. Click here to download the Netflix app. So I'll click there. As soon as you click, it'll say starting to download. Once that happens, you're done with this. You could exit out of here and go to downloads, and you'll see it's in progress, 45, 51. And there's your Netflix release. And you're just going to wait for that to say 100. Sometimes if you wait too long, when you come here, it's already done. So see how it's done already? It's that simple. To install it, you're going to hit Netflix, and then it's going to come to here. You may have seen something like this if you have a Fire Stick or if you've installed stuff on your phone. And then you're just going to click Install. I'm going to hit pause, and when it's finished, I'll be right back. All right, once it finishes installing, it'll say App Installed. I don't ever hit Open there. I just hit Done. And it's done. Swipe up. And there's Netflix. Let's try it out. Netflix. And you'll probably have to log on the very first time, join for a free month, or sign in right there. So click on the sign in, and give me a second while I sign in. I'll be right back. All right, I don't want you to see my... Oops. Hold on a second. I typed the wrong password. Give me a minute. Okay. It should be signing in any minute. It's not signing in. Hold on 1 second. I know what happened. I wasn't typing in yahoo.com. 1 second. And there we go. So I'm logged in now. I'll have to rewind to make sure I wasn't showing anything, like my password. All right, then. So this is your normal. Click anywhere. You can, let's see, Pandemic. And we'll try to see if this works, and then we'll quickly turn it off so we don't want any copyright infringement. And as you can see, it works. So let me hit stop. So that's how you get Netflix to work. All right. Now let's say you want, there's two ways. Oh, that's it. Let's say there's two ways you can, what I like to do is, let me close out of that and in here. So you don't want to, every time you come to your desktop, you don't want to have to launch your desktop. Like for instance, see, I have some shortcuts here. You don't want to have to launch it every time and go in there and then click Netflix so that you can get Netflix. What you want to do is you want to create a shortcut. There's two ways to do a shortcut. The first one is to hold this down and then just drag it here. And now you have a shortcut. You click that and boom, there's your Netflix. But I found a different way you can do it. So let's get rid of this from the desktop. An even better way, if you want something a little nicer, and you have to have Netflix installed in order for you to do this, is you hold down here. And then when you do, it brings open wallpapers. and widgets. The first thing I'll do is bring my wallpaper back to the way it was. It's a black hole. Now with living wallpaper, once it loads it, you've got to come down here and set it, whereas the other one, you set it up there. So I hit set wallpaper, and there's my living wallpaper. I have my black hole there, which is pretty cool. Hold it down again and go to widgets. See the widgets right there? Yep. Click on widgets, and you'll notice it defaults to some sort of Netflix. You hold it, and then you bring it to your desktop. And it's pretty cool. Now, what I like to do is I like to size this a little different. Like, I'll move it, and then I'll make it a little smaller right here. And then a little smaller here. Actually, maybe a little bigger there. Let's try this. Huh. There's a way where you can get it so that it shows more than just one thing. Anyway, there it is. So if you click on this, you can keep changing it. So let's get it to a nice size. Like, that's a perfect size the way I like it. I drag this and I'm going to put it to the bottom corner. And what happens now is every time you click that, it kind of changes, gives you a little preview. So that's pretty cool. Like, if you were watching something, you can just go right back to it. What I like to do really... because I don't see the pandemic here. So what I'll do is I'll just click on Netflix and it'll just bring up Netflix. But if you like that shortcut better than the other shortcut, then that's for you to decide. Let's go back to the here. So again, you could have that shortcut or you can hold on to this Netflix and drag it over. So it's your pick. That might be cool. That might be cool. You know what? I'm starting to like that better because I don't see pandemic here. And I'll keep messing around with this. Trending now. Continue watching. Popular. Let's see if I click on the trending now. Will that do anything? No, it doesn't. And again, I'm not watching any of those. So maybe that changes as you see stuff. But for now, I don't like this. It's a little too much. And that's my Netflix shortcut right there. We'll put that one on the top because that's the prime one. I've got a video that I'll be putting out. It may already be out on how to install the Prime Video as well. All right, let's throw one more widget on there. I'm gonna have the clock widget. Let's hold this. The thing with the clock widget is, yeah, there's two desktops. Put it right at the bottom. The clock widget doesn't always stay. I'm not sure why, but for the time being, it's staying. All right, you can see it's kind of late. It's Friday already. Hopefully this helped a little bit. Don't worry, I'm not sick. I don't have the coronavirus. If I do, just make sure you wipe your screen and wash your hands. But hopefully that helps. That'll show you how to install Netflix. It'll show you how to access the desktop. And if you recall, if you come here, the square, by the way, shows you all your windows. So you can start closing some of these windows. Browser and go to your iFit Cardio. Excuse me. Again, I'm not sick. And then this is what you normally do. And if you want to... disable privileged mode just in case you think someone's coming over to fix your machine or anything. The same way you do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, 1,005, 1,006, 1,007, 1,000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and privileged mode false. So now when the guy comes, you don't have to worry about him going into privileged mode. All right, guys. Hopefully that helped. Now you know how to install Netflix. One more time, you know how to go into privileged mode, how to get out of privileged mode, and you know how to put the shortcut on your desktop. If you like the one that shows you a few different things, then go for it. Or you can go for the simple one that I just showed you. Y'all have a good one. Stay safe. If you like what you saw, subscribe, hit the thumbs up, and we'll see you later.